Are you ready for some Procreate fun? Well, let's jump in!
Hi and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Brenda Bakker and I'm from the Netherlands. I'm currently working on a YouTube series on the Alfabet, which is based on the book Alfabet, Brushlettering for Everybody by Carla Kamphuis. For this letter, I'm going to use standard canvas, 2048 by 2048 pixels, and I've set it on 300 dpi. I'm working with my messy brush pen, and you can use any brush pen you want. And for coloring, I will be using the gouache brush from Procreate, which you can be found on their painting. So that's all. So let's hop in. So we're going to start with normal canvas. This is 2048 pixels by 2048 standard, and I've got it on 300 dpi. As usual, I'll be working with my messy brush pen, and for this letter I'm going to make a thick downstroke and slightly upwards thinner. So thick, thin, and I'm going to do a thick, thin again. Okay, and now I'm going to do a small swirl from this angle on with light pressure, and I'm going to end with a little bit more pressure. So like this, light, 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 thicker. So I think this is a cute capital U with a swirl. I'm going to center it. And on that layer, I'm going to create a clipping mask like this. And I'm going to darken my color a huge amount. And I'm going to, what was it? Artistic? No, I'm always messing those two up. I'm going to my gouache and it's in painting. So I'm going to do the downside of the letter with some extra dark shadows. And because it's a clipping mask, it will only give color to the layer below. So it doesn't go outside of the lines. So, and I'm going to create a lighter color. So I'm going back to the color I was. Going to create a lighter color on top of that. And I'm going to color in the upper parts of the letter. And here comes the fun part. I'm going to blend it. My light will come to from this angle, so I'm going to create also a lighter bit here. And on this way, a little more. So, and now I'm going to blend it. Go into my smudge tool. I'm going to use the same tool. So leave my pencil on it so it will automatically get the same shape. And I'm going to blend a little bit smaller, I guess. And I want to get it a little smooth transaction, but not too smooth. And I'm going to pull a little bit of the darker color towards the top. So I get a little more light and dark changes over here. So because the light comes from this angle, it's going to look like it's a little bit rounded. I'm going to do this also on this side. Perhaps choose a little bit of the same height where your shadows and your lighting will come from. Your lighting. So like so, I'm going to do this here also, create a little bit of shadow, I'm going to smudge it here again, so it will look, it will get, it's going underneath there. I'm going to make this a little smooth again. Like so. I think I like it like this. So I'm going to create a new layer on top. Also put in that clipping mask. And I don't actually need a clipping mask, but I do that all the time when I do something on top of the same letter. So I'm going to, what should I do? I'm choosing the same brush and I'm going to choose a white. I'm going to choose a white on the same brush, And on the layer on top, also on the clipping mask, I'm going to put down a highlight. Make them a little smaller. So it will have a little bit of a glossy look. Going to smudge that also. Just a little highlight here. And I think that looks nice. A little bit softer. Yes. And now I'm going to duplicate the layer that's at the bottom, my basic layer. And I'm going to work with a layer that's all the way at the bottom. I'm going to make it black by choosing black, choosing select, and choosing fill layer. So now I've got a black layer underneath here. And I'm going to create an extra shadow here. Going to play with the opacity for like an N95. That's my favorite Tombow color. So now I've got created an extra shadow underneath, and you can see it very well, I guess. So this is the letter for this episode. I hope you like this, and see you in the next one. Thank you for watching this episode until the very end. If you like this video and think I've earned it, please give this video a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't already. More detailed tutorials can be found on SkillShare. These and all other links can be found in the description below. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!